Life takes our meaning when you become motivated, set goals and charge after them in an unstoppable manner. And today, at BTF Legal World, we are speaking with somebody who more than personifies this saying. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for Mr. Hemant Kumar, Group General Counsel, L&T Limited. So, welcome to BW Legal World Dialogues. You are somebody who's had this really awe-inspiring journey in law for over or around 40 years. How has this journey been for you, sir? And who actually motivated you to get into law?
Asimya, thank you very much for asking this very interesting, I would not say question, but query to me. I come from a family of judges, corporate counsel, advocates. In my childhood, the dining table conversation with my father were around only legal matters. So I would say my father, my uncle, and other senior members of the family motivated me to take law as a profession, and therefore I opted for law.
So you started your journey with practicing in law before you moved to an in-house role. Please tell us something about that.
Asima, in my view, even today, that whether you go to become a judge or in-house counsel, you must have the basic knowledge of trial court, district court. And therefore, I started my practice as an advocate. Though I had the ambition to straightway practice in High Court and Supreme Court, but my father advised me to understand the basic procedure law before the trial court. So I spent a couple of years in the district court, and thereafter I moved to the High Court.
Great, sir. And if I'm not wrong, you started your after this you started your journey at SBI, and after that you moved into bigger roles in bigger industries. So how did that shift happen for you?
Asima, after completing my 3-4 years journey as an advocate, I decided to move in-house counsel. Because almost in all my family, they were in service, like my father was a judge, uncle was a judge. So I just appeared in All India Written Examination of State Bank. I qualified in 85 batch and joined State Bank of India, Calcutta, as an in-house counsel. Thereafter, I joined Steel Authority of India in 1990. After Steel Authority of India, I joined a couple of private industries, especially the Ispat Industries, which was headed by the Junior Mittals. After Ispat Industry, I joined Reliance, ADIG Group, Anil Dhirubhai Mane Group. Thereafter, I joined as a Group General Counsel with SR Group. And finally, I joined in 2016, Larsen & Toubro, one of my dream institution, as a Group General Counsel.
Sir, a dream absolutely for so many of us out there. So we are in a time of pandemic. Lucky that we are able to meet in person finally. But in your career of about 40 years, there must have been many ups and downs. Was there a time in life when you thought, here is a difficult time, nothing is working out, but you moved on and achieved your goal?
Asima, let me tell you, last 40 years, with the grace of the God and the support of the parents, family members and hard work, my journey was very smooth, I would say. Yeah, around 25 years back, one incident I would like to share for the youngster also, that in 1 year I could not get promotion, and that affected my health very seriously, and that also affected my family atmosphere. But Thereafter, after 2-3 years, again I gained all the opportunity. I got all the opportunity, and it became very successful journey. But my message to youngster that, see, journeys, all the journey are not easy and not smooth. Somewhere you will have to face the bumpy roads. And if such bumpy roads you cross, then you will become a successful manager. Therefore, don't get yourself, depressed by not having, say, a small thing in 1 year, 2 year, and spoiling your health as well as family atmosphere. Better forget that and go ahead and think about positivity. And I'm sure that if you have the acumen, you have the zeal, you will excel and you will be a successful manager.
Absolutely, sir. Still waters do not make great sailors. So what a profound, awe-inspiring journey. Thank you so much, sir, for that. So, in times of pandemic, I'm sure you've seen so much, your knowledge is so vast. What have been the three key learnings through this time, and what do you look for in a lawyer of the future? What are those three things that a lawyer must have today to have a successful career?
At least for the in-house counsel, I can say I cannot have the experience of currently outside or advocate. So I will focus more on in-house counsel. During pandemic, as a legal head, it was my prime duty to connect myself with my peers, my subordinates, whether they are safe, whether they have any problem. And therefore, every day I started interacting with all my peers for a couple of hours. During that interaction, we used to ask about their health. If somebody needs any support, our company used to provide immediate support. Second thing, since we had a little relaxed time, I would say, otherwise. So we try to update our day-to-day knowledge through different ways, through presentation, through other ways. And Asima, let me tell you, there are nothing shortcuts to success. You are doing a very hard work, honest hard work, according to me, who can't achieve any success. So during pandemic, we had many problems, but with the support of the management, with the support of my team members, we could overcome all the problems in a very positive way and without affecting our day-to-day work in the office.
So what are the three things that will make a good in-house lawyer in today's time?
Asima, as I told you that there is no shortcuts to any success. So whether you are having 30 years or 40 years experience or 5 years experience, in my view, you have to keep yourself abreast with all the latest development, not on the legal field, but also if you are dealing with a particular business, you as an in-house counsel should know the business. So thereafter you can really deliver your jobs successfully. Second important is, that we live in fast changing times currently, where technology is progressing very hard and very rapidly, and it is impacting enormously to the society. So my suggestion to all in-house counsel is to understand the technology, apply in your profession, in your department. Artificial intelligence is giving a lot of benefit to us. And these are the very important things which I suggest to in-house counsel to implement in day-to-day work. That way I'm lucky that in my family, my daughter Nupur and my son-in-law Satish, they are engineers, so they guide me like my son, who is a lawyer, a young lawyer, and my wife, who is a partner with a law firm. They are guiding me and updating me on a legal day-to-day updates. Since I am very busy in my day-to-day work, so their input are very important for me, and I request all the in-house counsels to follow the same practice in your day-to-day life.
So who have been your guiding North Stars in this amazing journey of yours?
Asima, thank you very much. It's very interesting. And my very favorite, point in my life. My biggest mentor was my father. Not in developing my knowledge bank, but also teaching how to become a successful lawyer. So profession-wise, my father is a number one mentor. Of course, equally important is my mother, who taught me how to become a true human being and maintain discipline in life. So she has also, until date, contributing a lot in my profession and my life. And after marriage, my wife Karuna, who is also in legal profession and partner with the law firm, influenced me a lot in my personality development and also become a successful in my profession. So these three individuals are my mentors.
So you are a part of a large group. You have so many people who work with you. It would be interesting to know your take on managing a work-life balance and handling the pressures of life in today's time.
Asima, this is also very relevant in this fast-growing organization and industry. I believe that if you maintain a little bit of calmness, clarity, and also maintaining a balance between your profession and your family life, you can achieve and you can address stress and pressure of your day-to-day work. I always advise and suggest to my peers, wherever I have worked, whether in L&T or my past organization, that whatever pressure you have, professional pressure, you just hand over at your office place and go with a free mind to your home, have fun in your family, instead of carrying this stress, office address, stress to your family. This is one. Second is important is that other than office stress, even a person may have family problems or stress. So those stress are very relevant. I remember one of the very senior member of my earlier organization said, a man having no stress is like a dead man. So we are not a dead man. So if you maintain a good calmness, clarity in your life, you can easily address this pressure.
So what is a day in the shoes of Mr. Hemant Kumar is like? What is your team and day-to-day work?
Asima, I strongly believe that my colleagues and peers in my team are my greatest strength. At corporate level, we have a small team of around dozen in-house counsel. But yeah, overall in L&T, we have a large team and each business, depending on the size of the business, they have separate teams. Any HOD, whether in L&T or anywhere you are working, you have to always think that these youngsters, those who are working with you, are your real assets. If you properly nurture them, if you properly groom them, they will not be a great support to you, but also be a great asset for the organization and also for the country. So, in my career for the last 20 years, I'm heading some organization. So I follow the principle to A, groom this youngster so that tomorrow they can also become head legal or anywhere they want to go. Also, you teach them how to become a successful legal head. For that, to keep everybody and all the peers abreast with the latest development of law. And as I told earlier, that also should know a little bit about the business. And thereafter, you will find that things are very easier for you.
Absolutely, sir. I think a great leader is somebody who can cultivate more leaders just as you are. So, what a great journey. So, And what does the day outside of work look like for you? Is there a bucket list, and are there things yet to achieve for Mr. Hemant Kumar?
Asima, I have a dream that whenever I retire, I want to groom final year students of law or those who have just passed out law degree as a advocate, as a judge, as a in-house counsel. I want to go to the remote area of India where the young lawyer or young advocates or those who are in the final year, they do not have the means to come to Mumbai or come to Delhi for practice. So I want to groom them, train them that if you have a law degree, only becoming a lawyer and judge or in-house counsel are not the only your destination. There are 25, 26 better opportunity available in the market, and you can try those opportunity. Say for example, one wishes to become a legal editor. He or she can join any press media. So similar thing, they have the opportunity. So my ambition of future ambition is very clear, to groom them without any monetary benefit from my side or any commercial way, but to free of cost to those guys. Not only groom them for on a law subject, but also if they want to join legal profession before the court, what are the etiquettes, what are the dressing style I want to teach them. Say they want to, if somebody wants to become in-house counsel, what are the challenges to become in-house counsel. If they have all the ideas, all the information, all the qualities, I think those youngster can become a successful advocate, judge, and in-house counsel in future.
Absolutely, sir. And speaking of legal editors, maybe you can make a pitch for them to join DW Legal World.
Oh, sure, why not?
Thank you, sir. So you've been an integral part of our jury for 40 Under 40. What is your message to the leaders of the future and the young brigade of lawyers?
Asima, let me tell you very frankly, that whatever I have exercised and practiced, same thing I would like to share with my colleagues who have 40 or 40 ever in-house counsel years in-house counsel. I'm a very positive thinker and always take a decision based on well thought and proactive approach. So first message to 40 and 40s is that have a positive thinking. And also I would advise that never work for popularity. If something is if some matter is referred to you and sometimes you are under pressure to give opinion in lines with the management decision, and you find that it is not in terms of the law, you should be very frank before the management that this is not in the lines of the law, and therefore we should not go ahead in this matter. Because if you are just becoming a yes man for the organization, you are causing a huge problem for the organization. If something goes wrong, the first thing, it will cause a huge loss to the organization, it will be a loss to the branding and marketing of the organization, and therefore you should be very careful while giving any opinion. Second thing, always try to create a climate of optimism and high moral values with your folks. These things are very important for every organization. These are also relevant for your day-to-day family, affairs. Therefore, if you follow all these two, three important mantras, you will be a successful in-house counsel, you will be a successful leader.
Thank you so much, Mr. Kumar. Have the gumption to call a spade, that's your last word to the audience. So thank you so much, sir, for this opportunity that you've extended to us to interview you. It's been a lovely experience. Thank you so much for being with BW Legal World in this session.
Ashima, thank you very much that you have not put up a very hard and tough questions to me. And I am thankful to you and Business World for giving me an opportunity to share my experience, my journey of 40 years in the legal profession, both as a lawyer and as an in-house counsel. Wish you all the best. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Mr. Kumar. Thank you.